Good evening, students. In our last lecture, we have started with the loops control structures in C programming language. We have seen the syntaxes and the technical difference between all the types of loops available in C programming language. So, we will see the first program using loop. That is, write a program in C to print the first 50 even numbers. Say. Now, we know that what do you mean by even number? A number which is completely divisible by 2 is called even number. Okay, so our task is to print the first 50 even numbers. It means that we need to take a loop in such a way that we start with 1 and which goes till 100, and the increment must be done by 2. A simple logic where we increment I value by 2 instead of incrementing the I value by 1. So we'll see that program now. We start with the header files stdio.h and hash include conio.h. void main. Inside the void main, we'll declare one variable I for loop purpose. Then clear screen, we'll clear the screen. In for loop, we'll write a loop in such a way that we start with 0 and it ends with 100, and it is incremented every time. The iteration will be incremented by 2. It means I will be jumped by step 2, I equal to I plus 2, because it will first print 0. After printing 0, we want to skip the odd numbers and directly we want to jump to even numbers. So, we will increment I by 2 here. So, we will write an assignment statement I equal to I plus 2 to increment the iteration by 2 steps. Now, in this for loop, it will check whether I is less than or equal to 100 or not. So, here I value is 0, right? So the condition is true and it allows us to enter into the loop and it prints the value of I, that is 0. After printing the I value 0, it goes back to increment the value of I by 2. Because of this line I equal to I by I plus 2, it increments I value by 2. Now I value becomes 2. And again it goes back to check the condition. Here again 2 is less than 100. So it allows you to print 2 also because the condition is true. Like this, it goes on printing all the even numbers. Next number that is to be printed by this for loop will be 4. Next will be 6 and so on till 100. So this for loop will going to print the first 50 even numbers. And at the end of this for loop, it prints all 50 even numbers, first 50 even numbers, and getH will hold the output somewhere on the screen, and this closing bracket will close the program. So this is a small program which prints the first 50 even numbers. If I want to print, say, the first 50 odd numbers, we have to do only a small change into the previous program. Instead of initializing I value to 0, we will start I value with 1. So here if you see, in this program, here in the for loop, I value is initialized to 1 and the remaining part we kept as it is. I less than equal to 100, I equal to I plus 2. It means again we want to jump from 1 to 3. It means by jump by 2 steps. So, I must be incremented by 2. So, here I is initialized to 1. It goes back to check the condition. If the condition is true, it allows you to enter into the for loop and allows you to print the value of I. So, here the condition is true. It prints the first value of I, that is 1. After printing the value 1, it goes back to increment the value of I. Here in the third part, that is I equal to I plus 2. So, previous I was 1. 1 plus 2 is 3 now. After I value becomes 3, it goes back to check the condition again. If the condition is true, it allows you to print 3 also. And in this case, the condition is true. Like this, after printing 1, 3, the next number to be printed will be 5 by this for loop. Because I is incremented by 2 here. 3 plus 2 becomes 5 and it allows you to print 5 also because the condition is true. Like this, it goes on printing all the first 50 odd numbers. And it stops its execution when the condition becomes, for loop condition becomes false. And here getSet will hold the output somewhere on the screen, and then this closing bracket will close the program. So this is a simple program to print first 50 odd number. Now the third program is to print a table for a given number. Now we know that how to print the table for a given number, or how to generate a table for a given number in mathematics. Similar logic we are going to implement this program. So we know that whenever we generate the table of a given number, we need to multiply that number to all the digits from 1 to 10. So we need a for loop which will go from 1 to 10 in forward direction. So that is called a forward loop in this case. So we need another number whose table is needed by the user. So in this program, we are going to declare two different variables. One is for for loop purpose, that is I, and another is the number whose table is to be generated. So here we declare in this program, in main program, we will declare two variable of integer type, integer I comma number. I is we are going to use for loop, and number where we actually store the value of a number whose table is to be generated. The next line, the clear screen will clear the screen. On the fresh screen, will prompt a message to the user to enter a number whose table is required. Using scanf statement, will read that value, that number, and will store that number into number variable here. Once you get the number, we need to run a for loop which goes from 1 and it ends when I value becomes 10. So we will write a forward loop like this in C program, where I is initialized to 1, semicolon, we write the terminating condition, that is I less than equal to 10, semicolon, I must be incremented by 1, that's why we write I plus plus here. So this is a simple forward loop which starts with 1 and it ends with 10, and every time I value gets incremented by 1. So initially here I value is 1. After this initialization, it goes back to check the second part, that is the condition. If the condition is true, it allows us to enter into the for loop. Here the condition is true in this case. So this printf statement gets executed. In that printf statement, if you see how it is written, percentage d into percentage d equal to percentage d. In this case, the first percentage d is nothing but the iteration value of I, current value of I, into the given number, that is num, and equal to is the result. It means here we are actually performing the product of iteration I and the number, and this equal to, after the equal to sign, there is another percentage d which actually print the product of two numbers, that is I and number. So how many times this loop will going to be executed? This loop will going to be executed 10 times, because it is started with 1 and it is going to end when I becomes 10. So whatever may be the number that you provide into the scanf statement, that number gets multiplied with the value of I, and actually the product gets generated. Now if you see in this case, I value is 1 and the condition is true. The first time, suppose the number entered by the user is 3 and I want to generate the number table of number 3. In this case, first multiplication that happens in this program will be 1 into 3, and it equals to 3 by this statement. After printing this 3, it increments the value of I by 1. Here I value becomes 2, and then again the condition is true. Next multiplication that happens in this program is 2 into 3, and that goes to 6 after equal to symbol. Okay, so this becomes 6. 2 into 3 is 6. Like this, it performs the multiplication. When I becomes 10, the last multiplication that happens in this program is 10 into 3, that is 30. So like this, it prints a table of a given number.